Hello and hi friends, welcome to our channel Rising Sun.
Hello and hi friends, our today topic of discussion would be the stress and strain elasticity behavior of materials. Basically, the materials are classified as either ductile or brittle depending on their stress strain characteristics. For example, if we talk about the ductile material, that is copper, and the brittle, that is glass. So let us discuss it further in our slides. So friends, now we are going to discuss the first part, that is strain. A piece of material, when subjected to equal and opposite forces, there is a change in its shape and size. It is called strain. And how we are going to calculate it? That is, strain is equal to delta L divided by L into 100. E is the strain, it is a ratio and it has no unit. L is the original length of the bar and the delta L is the change in the length of a bar. So friend, this is the strain. So friend, our next topic is stress. The internal forces that are set up in a material to resist the change of shape, this resisting force is called stress. So friend, as we see, there is a uniform bar LM of cross-sectional area A be acted upon by equal and opposite forces P at the ends along the axis of the bar. Let any section axis perpendicular to the axis of the bar divide it into two parts, that is E and F. Consider the equilibrium of the portion E. At the end L, there is a force P for equilibrium, and equal and opposite force P must act on the face XX. Hence, the stress, that is P on axis, is equal to P upon A, that is kilogram per square centimeter. So friend, this is the stress, and we see the unit, that is kilogram per square centimeter. The bar will undergo a change in length under the action of external forces P, and the L is the original length, as we see in our earlier part in the case of strain, and delta L the change in length. Then the strain E is equal to delta L upon L, that is the strain. So we have revised the both the parts, stress and strain. Now friends, we are going to discuss some terms that are related to the different conditions. The tensile stress or strain. If the force P is tensile and tends to elongate the bar, then the stress and strain in the material is tensile. Then compressive stress / strain. So friends, the compressive stress or strain, if the force P tends to decrease the length of the bar, then it is called compressive. Then the third one is shearing stress or strain. If the external forces acting on a piece of material tend to slide one layer over the other, then it is called shearing. So friends, we see the shearing stress Q is equal to P upon A, as we have seen in the earlier case. And the shearing strain, that is equal to C C dash upon B C. So this is the shearing strain. So friends, we have understand the different terms that are related to different conditions. Now let us move further. Now the term elasticity. Let us understand the elasticity. The property of a material by virtue of which it regains its shape and size when the external forces is removed is called elasticity. Then elastic limit. A material remain elastic up to a certain stress is called elastic limit. Then permanent set. As the name defined itself, the strain which remains behind after the removal of forces, that is called permanent set. Plastic stage. If the elastic limit is exceeded, the material does not remain elastic, but it enters the plastic stage. So friend, this is elasticity. Now let us move further. Now the friends, it's the Hooke's law. Upon a certain value of stress, it is found that the stress is proportional to strain for a given material. And this is called the Hooke's law. The ratio of stress to strain is called Young modulus or modulus of elasticity. In case of shearing stress, the ratio is called the modulus of rigidity. And we see that the unit is equal to kg per centimeter square. So friend, this is the Hooke's law. So friends, this is the stress strain curve of a mild steel. In our next slide, we are going to discuss this slide, this diagram, how the different stages are maintaining while a mild steel going through a different stages. So this is the stress strain curve of a mild steel. Now let us move further and discuss it. So friends, now this is the stress strain curve of a mild steel which we are going to study. As we see in the graph, the point A corresponds to the limit of proportionality. Now the friends, what is the limit of proportionality? So friends, the limit of proportionality is the value of stress up to which the stress and strain remain proportional is called the limit of proportionality. So the point A corresponds to the limit of proportionality. Then the point B. Point B, it is the point where the mild steel begins to yield. That is why it is called yield point. Then the point C, it is the point in which the mild steel continuously yielding from B to C. Then the D, from C to D, the material is acting ductile. M is the local yielding begins, a neck of rest is formed, and it is called the ultimate or maximum stress. Then the finally F, where the specimen fractures. The extension continues till the specimen fractures. So this is how the mild steel strain and strain curve is being studied. So friend, let us discuss the ductile materials. Any material that can be subjected to a large strains before it fracture, it is called ductile material. The ductility of the material is it percent elongation or percent reduction in area at time of fracture. Let us see the formula. Percent elongation is equal to LF minus LO divided by LO into 100. LO is the original length and LF is the length at fracture. Similarly, friends, the brittle material that exhibit little or no yielding before failure are referred to as brittle materials. The classic example of brittle material is a gray cast iron. So friend, further, ductile material, the percent reduction in area is another way to specify ductility. it is defined within the region of necking. The percent reduction in area is equal to AO minus AF divided by AF into 100. AO is the original cross-sectional area, AF, area of neck at the fracture. Friend, next one is creep, the phenomena of the slow growth of strain under a steady load is called creep. Then one of the most important factor, that is factor of safety. It is obvious that the greater stress to which the material may be subjected in practice must be considerably less than the ultimate stress. This stress is called the working stress. The ratio ultimate stress divided by working stress is called the factor of safety.
Hi friend, thank you for watching the video and please subscribe the video. Thank you.